Welcome the students of class 7. Welcome everyone to our social science e-learning class. And today in this class we are going to discuss another subunit from your history chapter 8. And the name of the subunit is Nathpanthis, Siddhas and Yogis. Okay. And another subunit I will discuss after that, Islam and Sufism. The first part of Islam and Sufism. Okay. And it is present in your history book page number 110. So open your history book page number 110 and follow the subunit. That in previous classes you have learned about the Alavars, Nanars and some different philosophical ideas about the Allama Prabhu Basabhanna and Akka Mahadevi, as well as the ideas of Ramanuja and Shankara. Now today we are going to discuss another new type of thinking that was popular in the medieval period and emerged as a main another stream to worship the supreme god. And before starting the chapter, I am also starting the subunit, I am also mention one thing that the saints of Maharashtra, that subunit is not a part of your syllabus, so it will not come in your upcoming PT2 examination. Okay, so we are beginning from Nathpanthi Siddhas Yogis and Islam Sufism. So what happened that some religious groups at the time in medieval period, they criticizing the ritual of and the other aspects of conventional religion. Conventional religion means the conventional Hinduism, that the worship of the goddess, gods and goddesses, and also the Vedic rituals. So they are very much against all this, and they are also against the social order, means the caste system like Brahman, Kshatriya and all these. So what are the main idea of these people, that they using simple and logical arguments, they explained that what was God, what is God and how to reach towards him. So Nathpanthi Siddhacharyas and Yogis said that formal rejection of the family life and the simple, they led a simple life, and the path of salvation lay in the meditation of meditation on formless ultimate reality and also the realization of oneness with it. If you realize that ultimate God, that the single ultimate reality, then that is the day when someone gets salvation. Okay. And they achieve this through a system of various practices like yogasana, breathing exercise or pranayama and meditation. And the Nathpanthis, they are actually originated from the today's UP in Gorakhpur. Okay, so Gorakhnath, so these are, and the followers of Gorakhnath and the other disciples and the followers, they are known as Nathpanthis. Okay, Siddhas also another group, the similar type of yogis, and they also another type of the devotional groups. And you know that in our Ayush ministry, that Ayurvedic, Yoga, Unani, Siddha and Homeopathy, so on these departments, one method is the method of treating people, okay, like allopathy and homeopathy, and like Ayurvedic, it is also another method, that is Siddha. So this is also, these people invented that method of Siddha. Okay, and you know that yogis, that you have already learned various yogasanas in your school. So those are yogis who invented those things. So through yoga, the awakening, they awake their kundalini, means the power inside from their body, and they can realize that their soul, what is the, there was no difference, there is no difference between the individual soul or their soul with the ultimate soul or ultimate reality. So that is their method of devotion. Okay, students. So now we are going to discuss about the Islam and Sufism. That the Sufis believe that the love and devotion to God and compassion towards all fellow human beings. The saints had much common with the Sufis, so much so that it is believed that they adopted many ideas from each other. So the saints from the mainstream Hinduism, they also accepted a lot of things from the Sufis, and Sufis also accepted a lot of things. So in this way, in medieval period, when Islam arrived in India, and so Islam, the idea of Islam, that the belief of one God also mixed with the Sanatana or ancient religion, and together and with the ideas of Upanishad also mixed within it, and they create a golden era of devotion or bhakti. And the Sufis, they also one of the part of this period. And Sufis mainly the Muslim mystics, but there are some little bit difference from the mainstream Islam, that the Sufis rejected outward religiosity and emphasized love and devotion to God and compassion towards all fellow human being. They also very much compassion towards all fellow human beings. They believe that God exists in everyone, and their only motto of the life is to emphasize love and devotion to God. Islam propagated some strict submission or monotheism, means the worship of single God. But in this case of Sufis, it also and Islam also reject idol worship and believed in simplified rituals of worship, such as the collective prayers or namaz. Okay, so in this way the simplified rituals are introduced and practiced inside the Islam. But what is the difference between the Islam, mainstream Islam, and Sufis? That a lot of Muslim scholars, they also developed a holy law or a book of law that is called Sharia, and they said all the Muslims should maintain their lifestyle through this Sharia. But the Sufis often rejected the elaborate rituals and codes of behavior mentioned in the Sharia, and they sought codes of behavior, and they shout union with God like as much as a lover seeks his beloved. So they are actually worshipping the God or Allah, whatever, like a lover loved his or her beloved. Okay, so in this way, and they also composed various poems expressing their feelings and rich literature in prose, and they also include music on it and express their feelings towards God. In Central Asia, in medieval period, lot of famous Sufis also born, like Ghazali, Rumi, and Sadi, and they too believed that heart can be trained to look the world in a different way. To look the world in a different way, the heart can be trained. So, what are the main rituals of the Sufis? That the Sufis use various different their own rituals, such as zikr. Zikr means chanting the name of or any sacred formula to worship the God. Contemplation means deep realization or deep realistic thought, deep thinking. Sama means singing. Raqs mean dancing, one type of special type of dance when they are very much fond of God, and so they started singing and dancing. Okay. So discussion of parables means the small two-liners or some small poems, and breath control technique. And they were divided among silsilas or genealogy of Sufi teachers. This type of the Sufis, they also divided among various silsilas, okay, such as the Surawardi, Chisti, Naqshbandi, etc. And each of them following a slightly different method or tariqa of instruction and ritual of practice. Okay, so this is slight different among them, but all of them, they believed in the similar type of ideology, that is the Sufi. So next class I am going to discuss about some important silsilas that were very much famous in India, and today also the places where those the Sufi teachers, they lived these and they left their earthly body. So those places also become a very popular religious places, such as the Dargah of Hazrat Nizamuddin in Delhi, okay, Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia in Delhi, and also Khaja Moinuddin Chisti in Ajmer Sharif. Okay, so students, that's all from today's class. Next class, I'll discuss the rest of the portion. Thank you for watching.